Right, so everyone has a bucket list, don't they? For most normal people, it's stuff like seeing the Northern Lights, writing your novel, or travelling across the globe. Whereas mine, quite simply, is to visit the San Siro. Why? Because for the first 10 years of following football, AC and Inter Milan were the coolest things in the fucking world. Chelsea are, and unfortunately always will be, my team. But the Milan sides of the mid-noughties to early 2010s played a massive part of me falling in love with the game. Why have I not been yet, though? It's been around for ages and it's not that far away. Well, that would be because the one time I went to Milan, with the sole motivation of dragging my mates to the stadium, Muse, yeah, fucking Muse, were playing a gig there and the place was closed. So when the group stage draw put us in with AC Milan, I couldn't miss this chance. And there'd be no shitty rock band with a conspiracy theorist frontman to stop me this time. Get an Uber to Gatwick for around 6 a.m. on the day of the game. After getting told off for vlogging whilst going through security, trying and failing to get into the BA lounge, and getting some breakfast, my dad and I go to Spoons and wait for my mates to arrive. Board the 8:35 Wizz Air flight to Milan, where virtually the whole plane is made up of overweight white blokes in designer clobber, all secretly regretting having a pint at 6:30 a.m. Touchdown in Milan, make the task of buying train tickets far more difficult than it actually was, then head into the city. When we arrive, we want to go and pick our tickets up. Chelsea have conveniently placed a collection point miles away from anywhere remotely useful to us on the same day as a metro strike in Milan until 3 p.m. On our 35-minute walk there, we take in the streets of Milan, some strange castle thing, and find the BNP's European office. Get to the hotel Chelsea are based in, and for the first time in my life, I collected a Euro away ticket legitimately, with my own name on and everything. Chelsea handing out free mats in Milan, which is kind of them, but also utterly useless, as none of the ticket collection point, where we're staying, or the San Siro are on it. We grab some beers around the corner, which are surprisingly strong, and I've had nothing to eat since my 6:15 airport breakfast, so they hit me instantly, and I already feel a headache coming on. Finish the beers, then jump on the world's slowest moving tram, or we pass a Nottingham Forest theme bar. After locating and checking into our Airbnb, we follow the sound of songs about shagging corpses and overrated Dennis Wise goals to find the Chelsea, where we then get back on the beers. I'd stayed in this area when I went to Milan a couple years back, and it was a cool, buzzing little area with nice restaurants and cool bars. However, within 2 days, the Chelsea completely ruined it and turned it into a congested alleyway of an overpriced Irish bar. We sit drinking our beers and the crowd slowly starts to disperse. We're not sure why they're heading to the ground 2 hours early and assume it's because they're too thick to realise the game kicks off at 9 in Italy and not 8. We finish our last round an hour before kickoff and head on the metro to the San Siro, with one Milan fan engaging in a chant off of a group of Chelsea fans and ends up winning, as their songs are more than just a player's name followed by some vocal balls. Once out of the metro, the stadium looks absolutely glorious. You can hear the roar of the Milan fans miles away. Annoyingly, you don't get much chance to take in the glory of the Stadio Giuseppe Meazza, as you're rammed through 5 minutes of the most vigorous security checks ever, where they search for weapons, flares and portable chargers to confiscate. It comes apparent to us at this point why everyone left so early for the game. Once through security, we found ourselves at the bottom of a massive fucking marble run. It seemed to go on forever and the game kicked off in 5 minutes. Imagine walking up the world's biggest and most depressing helter-skelter. That's what you have to do to get to the away end of the San Siro. Newcastle, Man City and any other ridiculously high away ends, you've not got a patch on this gaff. Once at the top, I experienced possibly the most disorientating thing I've ever had at a football ground. I'm feeling dizzy as I've been walking in a spiral vertically for 5 minutes. I've lost my mates and my dad. I'm standing on a gangway with an unreserved seated away end behind me and some protective glass obscuring a quarter of the pitch in front of me. On top of that, the noise is absolutely deafening. All my senses were being attacked. Once we'd regrouped and found somewhere to stand, however, the place was amazing. Great view of the pitch, the loudest ground I've ever been in, and it just had an aura about it that few stadiums can match. The game itself is pretty even. Milan actually looked the better side, however, after 20 minutes, Tomori brings down Mount in the box, gets sent off and we have a penalty. I love Jorginho and always back him to score penalties, however this one I had no faith in. That whistling thing that European fans do, that never sounds that loud on TV, but fucking hell, in person it was insane. It was so intimidating. How the fuck do you even make that noise? Who teaches them? It's incredible. In England, all you get is a few fat blokes waving their arms behind you, whereas here you go a bit deaf. Anyway, Jorginho isn't bothered and he hop skips and jumps the ball into the net for 1-0. We dominate after that and we look really, really good. Just after the half hour mark, we string a nice move together. Aubameyang gets on the end of Mount's overhit pass to Sterling and buries it in the bottom corner, and we've essentially beaten AC Milan at the San Siro in 35 minutes. Our end is pretty good, but the Milan fans are non-stop. I know I've sucked their dick a bit in this video, but after years of experiencing the bland, half-assed, banter-obsessed English crowds my entire life, a proper atmosphere massively stands out to me. Half-time and I stay in my seat as the area selling food and drink looks like hell on earth. a narrow cylinder with tiny windows packed full of sweaty, drunk Chelsea fans. There was nothing worth going through that for. Second half was very dull as we managed the game and Milan struggled with 10 men. Our end is pretty quiet too. I think after the faff of getting into the ground and a whole day drinking in the sun means that people just aren't arsed. I mean, I know I can't be bothered to chant Chelsea, Chelsea, Chelsea for another 45 minutes. After missing a few chances and getting some Olays going, the game ended and we were back in control of the group. Being kept behind afterwards and having to face the curly whirly again was a pain, but it really was worth it to say I'd see my team win here. It's the best ground I've ever been to, and it'll be a truly sad day when this place is demolished. It's all just a game at the end of the day though, isn't it?
We're gonna play football, soccer, football.